All right, you guys, I have a big apology to make because I've been holding this off for a really long time, but I'm finally addressing it. I will now officially be redesigning your guys' YouTube thumbnails. So a bunch of you guys have submitted requests for YouTube thumbnail redesigns, and I'm finally catching up and addressing each one by the date they've came in. So if you still want yours to be redesigned as well, feel free to still email me. But without further ado, let's get to the first YouTube thumbnail redesign for this channel. The first YouTube thumbnail request that came in my inbox was this channel right here. So the video he wanted me to redesign the thumbnail was this video right here. You did a great job in getting a lot of views for this. This was a killer video that you did compared to all the other videos you've done. Yeah, this one knocked out of the park. I think this is your most viewed video. So more than happy to help you with kind of redesigning the thumbnail and seeing how we can make it look even better. So with that being said, let's get to the process. I have all your content right here that you mentioned in the email, just saying your name from Garang's Tech with GM. I want a thumbnail for this vid. Here's the image you gave me. And then I probably will include what your title was, how to install Samsung emulator on your PC. So the first thought is I see here in his image, he has a picture of the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go here and I searched it already, and I'm gonna try to look for like a PNG with a transparent background. If I can't find a transparent background for one of these, usually what I'll do is I'll either take one with a white background, hold into Photoshop, remove that background, and then put it in. If you don't have Photoshop, you can always go to remove.bg, save the picture, upload it here, remove it. I did a whole video on this right here if you want to see the tutorial on it, but that's also another way to get kind of a transparent background for this. So let me just grab this one right here. All right, cool. And I create all my YouTube thumbnails on PowerPoint. There will be maybe like once in blue moon where I'll try to design it in Photoshop, but I just find it easier to design in PowerPoint for some odd reason. So I have no idea why. That's just kind of how it is. I'm just gonna keep this entire footage running just so you guys can see my entire process of creating this. So here's his original video. Looks like he has also a PC. So let me get that going as well. Let me drag this in. Okay, cool. So we have this and that. All right, then we have his headshot as well. All right, and then the title of his video is just right here: how to install Samsung emulator on your PC. Okay, so we will take that. Next, what I'll do is I'll go to Unsplash. Let's just type in tech, try to see something that just stands out, you know, really poppy. Ooh, I like that. Okay, some of these images I find I might use for my own thumbnails as well, just saying, because you never know when you're gonna find a really cool image. So I really like this, you know, different. And the nice part about using PowerPoint is that the dimensions of a slide is the same dimensions of your thumbnail. So that's really good. And also I try to avoid anything on the bottom right here and in this corner right here as well, because that's where the timestamp is and then also where the red bar is gonna be. So any text you have, put it on the left side, and then everything else that you don't care about as much, you put on the right side. Also, if you do have a higher res camera, I always recommend that, but if you don't, that's fine. Thumbnails are usually pretty small to begin with, so people really won't know the difference. The most part, it does help though. You can see that, you know, the quality of this image, it's okay, it's not bad. I'm just gonna cheat a little bit. I'm gonna copy this glow effect here. I really like your positioning of your headshot here. This is good. All right, and try to just make everything like pretty big, maybe not that big. Sometimes you might like it, sometimes you might not, so just have to kind of play around with it. I don't know if I'm loving the background image. I may switch that up. Let's see here. And then another thing you can do is you can actually put it in reader view just to see how it's gonna look all big. I wanna really emphasize this part. The thumbnails are not easy, you guys. So I really like this text I got going on here. Samsung emulator. All right, let me make this bigger. Let's bring this down a little bit. Maybe you just kind of want to be a little exaggerate with everything, like contrast, everything. All right, see how that looks. Honestly, not bad. I'm not opposed to that. Let me know in the comments what you guys are thinking so far. This is what I'm doing real time. Let me see here. And this is also why I like to keep a bunch of my designs just in here, because that way I can pull from them, use them for other things. Switch that up a little bit. All right. Maybe go like that. that. Let's make that really big. My two favorite fonts for thumbnails are Montserrat and Lato. So let's try this one first, just because it's nice and bold and big. It's usually hard to see things. How do we get this in here? Okay, maybe switch this around a little bit. Get the front. It's difficult. Never good with always getting the thumbnails on the first try. All right, let's see how this looks. All right, so we're gonna get this one. Where do I go to click? All right, that's a no-go. Just go right here, copy image. All right, it's a little busy, so let me actually try to find something that's a little bit more subtle. So we're gonna go here to unsplash. Oh, I love that background. Only we can get that. So let's just type in abstract, something subtle. Okay, actually, maybe this. Go with this. Want something even less distracting. All right, we're gonna go with this image. Also, PowerPoint has a whole library of images. I never really seem to search them through there, but just keep that in mind when you are making yours that is an option. Like, there's too many things happening here. What to do. All right, let me get rid of this here, make this big. Let me actually flip this. Oh no, that doesn't make sense. All right, starting to get something here. This is also why I always wear a black shirt in all my thumbnails, because if you wear a very different type of shirt, which is totally fine, this is just my preference, it's so much easier to match every single thumbnail if I'm wearing like a black shirt like this one. I mean, I was in a fancy suit, but black will go with anything. So that's why I recommend, just if you do have a solid black shirt. But also, if red shirt's your theme, that pops out, that's also good. Let's see here. What can I do to make this make sense? All right, let's do 110 maybe, or 105. Okay, all right, so let's see if this might work. I want to get your head in here a little bit more. There you go. Make this bigger, that a little smaller, that like 60, maybe 65. Okay, we need all the fancy text effects for this one. Let's see here. Okay, I like that. And then let's do something with, it's got those colors in there. Then we'll make this black. Let's see, brightness. Okay. Oh, sharpness, here we go. So if you don't have a high definition picture, just increase the sharpness. Don't go overboard, because then it's gonna look like that, but can increase it a little bit. That'll make it a little bit sharper. And then let's make this 90, and we'll make this a little bigger. A little bit of shadow, make it white. Okay, so it's not perfect, but what do you guys think? I'm just about good with it. I like it. Showing the phone, installing PC, got your face in there. This was his original thumbnail, install Samsung Note 20 Ultra on computer. Honestly, I don't hate this thumbnail. I think it's very clear to the point. You're putting that on that computer, makes sense to me. Then we have this. So his might actually be better for people to clearly understand what the heck is going on with this. This one's a little bit more flashy, where it doesn't show the whole steps of like, hey, this emulator goes on this laptop. So I could actually take a few pointers from that. All right, so that was my take on recreating this YouTuber's thumbnail. If you guys did like this type of video, make sure you give a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of the day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.